Welcome back, students. Let's continue with the same chapter 5, that is language of chemistry. Now let us study the variable valency. Now some elements, they show variable valency. Variable valency means they show more than one value of the valency in different compounds. Okay, for example, now iron in FeO compound, it shows a valency of 2. Same iron in Fe2O3 compound. Okay, this is a different compound. The valency of iron becomes now 3. So we can see the variation in the valencies of the iron in the different types of the compounds. Right? So we will say iron is showing the variable valency. It is showing more than one value of the valency. Okay. Now, how to name such type of the compounds? FeO, this is known as the ferrous oxide, or you can say iron 2 oxide. 2 is the Roman numeral for the valency 2. In iron oxide, FeO or ferrous oxide, the iron valency is 2, that's why the Roman number is 2. Second is Fe2O3, this is known as ferric oxide, or you can write iron, the valency that is 3, and oxide. We can say that when a metal shows variable valency, the lower valency of the metal ends with the us. That's why the metal iron, ferrous, it will become ferrous, okay, O-U-S. In the second case, in the higher valency, here 3 is the valency, the name of the metal ends with a ic, so it becomes ferric oxide, okay. So for the lower valency, it becomes us, and for the higher valency, it becomes ic, I-C-ic. Okay, there are few other examples, like copper shows variable valency 1 and 2. Iron, we have already seen, variable valency is 2 and 3. Phosphorus, it has 3 valency as well as 5 valency. Okay, sulfur, it shows sometimes 2, 4, even 6. Okay, children? Now let us recall radicals. Radicals can be an atom, can be one atom, or they can be group of atoms. It can be more than one atoms, okay, and they have a charge on them. They can have either the positive or a negative charge on them, and then they behave as a single unit in a chemical reaction. They have their own specific characteristics, okay. So radicals, they can be an atom or group of atoms carrying the charge on them and behaving as a single unit. Okay, examples like ammonium radical. Ammonium radical, the formula is NH4, single positive. Now this is, it is a not one atom, it is a group of atoms, right? Nitrogen atom as well as hydrogen atoms are there, as well as the charge is there. So this is known as a radical. Okay, chloride radical. So it will be Cl, okay, and with a charge on it, that is a negative charge, single negative, chloride radical. Sodium radical, Na, and a single positive charge on it, okay. So this is also a radical. Now carbonate radical, CO3, 2 negative. Now this is carrying group of the atoms carrying a charge on them, so hence it is a radical. Now these radicals can be categorized into two types, acid radicals and basic radicals, simple radicals and compound radicals. So first category is acid radicals and basic radicals. Acid radicals, those radicals which are having the negative charge on them. You can see here chloride radical Cl negative, fluoride radical F negative, carbonate CO3 2 negative radical, SO4 sulfate radical, SO4 2 negative radical. Okay, so we can see they carry the negative charges on them, hence they are acid radicals. Okay, one more example is bromide radical. Okay, Br negative and so on. The second is the basic radical, the radicals having the positive charge on them, ammonium radical NH4 positive, sodium radical Na positive, potassium radical K positive, zinc radical Zn2 positive, and we can have aluminium Al3 positive, we can have iron Fe3 positive. All these radicals, they are carrying positive charge on them, hence they are in the basic radicals. Okay, next is the simple radicals and compound radicals. Simple radicals, they are made up of only one kind of atoms. Okay, and compound radicals, they are made up of two or more kind of atoms. Now look at the examples. Simple radical, chloride radical Cl negative, fluoride radical F negative, sodium radical Na positive, potassium radical K positive. And here we can have calcium radical Ca2 positive, okay, and so on. So over here we can see there is only one kind of atom present, hence they are in the simple radicals. Now compound radicals, made up of two or more kind of atoms. Here we have seen the hydroxide radical, carbonate radical, sulfate radical and ammonium radical. Here we can see that carbonate having carbon atom as well as the oxygen atoms, sulfate having sulfur atom as well as the oxygen atom, and so on. And we can have here sulfite also, SO3 2 negative radical, sulfite radical, then phosphate PO4 3 negative radical. Okay, in the previous class we studied positive radicals. Let's recall these positive radicals here. There are four categories: monovalent radicals, bivalent radicals, trivalent radicals and tetravalent radicals. Means monovalent radicals, radicals having valency 1. Bivalent radicals, radicals having valency 2. Trivalent radicals, radicals having valency 3. And tetravalent radicals, radicals having valency 4. Please remember, for the valency there is no need to mention the positive sign or the negative sign. Is it clear? Just you can mention the number in the valency. Okay, now first category is monovalent radicals, the radicals which have valency 1. Potassium K positive, sodium Na positive, copper 1, or you can say cuprous Cu1 positive, mercury 1 or mercurous Hg1 positive, silver Ag positive, ammonium NH4 positive and hydrogen H positive. Is it clear? So here in the bivalent you have valency 2, barium Ba2 positive, calcium Ca2 positive, magnesium Mg2 positive, manganese 2, it is Mn2 positive, or you can say manganous, zinc Zn2 positive, iron 2 or ferrous Fe2 positive, nickel Ni2 positive, cobalt CO2 positive, tin 2 means tennis Sn2 positive, lead 2, plumbus Pb2 positive, copper 2 or you can say cupric Cu2 positive. So over here we have seen copper has come in the monovalent and it has come in the bivalent also. So copper is having one valency as well as two valency. So lower valency we will call it as cuprous, and the higher valency we will be using ic at the end, so cupric. Okay, and mercury 2, it is known as mercuric, Hg2 positive. Here also mercury is in the monovalent category as well as the bivalent category. So monovalent, it will be termed as mercurous, Hg1 positive, and mercuric, Hg2 positive. Okay. Now here the third category, here trivalent means radicals which are having 3 valency. Aluminium Al3 positive, chromium Cr3 positive, iron 3, or you can term it as ferric, Fe3 positive. Now iron is in the bivalent as well as the trivalent category. So iron here in the bivalent, Fe2 positive, it is ferrous, and higher one, it is ferric, Fe3 positive. Okay, gold, auric, Au3 positive, arsenic, As3 positive, antimony, Sb3 positive. Okay, now here we have the last category, that is the tetravalent radicals, radicals which are having valency 4. So we have manganese here, 4 Mn4 positive. Okay, then we have we can see here bivalent manganese is known as manganous, Mn2 positive, and here manganic, Mn4 positive. So manganese show the variable valency and having 2 and 4 as a valency. Okay, tin 4, stannic, it is Sn4 positive. Now here also it was tin, so stannous, Sn2 positive, and here stannic, Sn4 positive, 2 and 4, okay, variable valency for the tin. Now lead 4, it is known as plumbic, Pb4 positive. Here it was plumbus, Pb2 positive. So lead is having 2 and 4 valency. Platinum, Pt4 positive. Okay, now these elements generally make use of the d orbital concept. Okay, so this we will going to study in our higher classes. Okay, now quickly check these negative radicals as well. Monovalent, bivalent, trivalent, and tetravalent negative radicals. So first category is monovalent negative radicals, those radicals which are having one negative charge, okay, or one valency. Hydroxide radical, or you can say hydroxyl radical, it is OH single negative. Fluoride, F single negative. Chloride, Cl single negative. Bromide, Br single negative. Iodide, I single negative. Bicarbonate, HCO3 single negative. Bisulfite, HSO3 single negative. Bisulfate, HSO4 single negative. Chlorate, ClO3 single negative. Hypochlorite, ClO single negative. Nitrite, NO2 single negative. Nitrate, NO3 single negative. Permanganate, MnO4 single negative. Aluminate, AlO2 single negative. Okay, second category is bivalent negative radicals, those radicals which are having valency 2. Carbonate, CO3 2 negative. Chromate is CrO4 2 negative. Dichromate formula, Cr2O7 2 negative. Sulfide, S 2 negative. Sulfite, SO3 2 negative. Sulfate, SO4 2 negative. Oxide, O2 negative. Zincate, ZnO2 2 negative. Thiosulfate, S2O3 2 negative. Okay, third category is trivalent negative radicals. So those radicals which are having valency 3, nitride, N3 negative. Phosphate, PO4 3 negative. Ferricyanide, Fe in bracket CN bracket close 6 3 negative. Okay, tetravalent, it is ferrocyanide, Fe in the bracket CN bracket close 6 4 negative. okay, these are generally, these tetravalents are generally complex ion, very big structures they have, which make use of the d orbital concept. This we will going to study in the higher classes. Okay children, now we will understand chemical formula. What is chemical formula? It is a symbolic representation of a molecule of a compound. It will show a molecule of a compound, or you can define the formula as formula of a compound represents the elements of which the compound is composed of and the number of the atoms of each element. Let us understand with the help of an example. Molecular formula of water. What is it? It is H2O. So H2O is a formula for the water molecule. Okay. Similarly, if we take the other example, molecular formula of sodium carbonate. Okay. Sodium carbonate. What is the molecular formula of sodium carbonate? Na2CO3. So this is the chemical formula of the sodium carbonate compound. Is it clear? Now what is the significance of the chemical formula? Chemical formula will tell you the elements which are forming a molecule. For example, water molecule. So here H2O formula is showing me that hydrogen element is present as well as oxygen element is there in the water molecule. Okay. Second is indicate, it tells you the number of the atoms of each element present in a compound. In this H2O compound, how many atoms of hydrogen are there? 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom is there. So this is fixed. 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom will make 1 molecule of water. So we can tell elements forming a molecule as well as the atoms of the each element present. Okay. Next is, it further indicates the fixed proportion by weight in which the elements are present. Now here 2 elements are present, hydrogen and oxygen, and there is 2:1 ratio of the atoms. So 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom. So this number is fixed. That's why the weight of these elements will also be fixed. Okay. Now this is MgO. MgO is a chemical formula for which compound? Magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide. Okay children. So here I can tell that magnesium element is also there and oxygen is there, and 1 atom of magnesium combines with 1 atom of oxygen. Okay. So this is fixed. Now let us understand the 3-step process to write the chemical formula. The first step is, the positive radical with its valency at the top is written first. So first you will going to write the positive radical, okay, with the valency, and later on you will going to write the negative radical with its valency. For example, calcium oxide. To make the formula of the calcium oxide, first you will write the positive radical. Calcium is a positive radical with the valency, that is Ca2 positive. 2 positive is the valency. And oxide. So oxygen is a negative radical with a 2 negative valency on the top. Okay. So first I am writing the positive radical, and then we are writing the negative radical. Okay. Now the second step is, the valency present on the top are interchanged and written on the base of the element. Over here we will write down calcium Ca2 positive and oxygen 2 negative. Now these valencies, 2 positive and 2 negative, will be interchanged and will be written on the base bottom of the element. So calcium valency goes to oxygen and oxygen valency goes to the calcium. So over here calcium goes to oxygen, here valency is 2 positive. Here I will write 2 at the base of oxygen, and oxygen 2 negative will go to the calcium. So 2 will come at the bottom of the calcium. Please remember that you don't have to include the positive and the negative signs while doing the interchange. Okay, so please don't write positive and negative here. The last step is the final formula is written by writing the simplest ratio. So we will copy down this final one, Ca2O2. Okay, and we will try to simplify it. Means if the valencies are divisible by a common factor, then divide and simplify the formula. Here 2 ones are 2 and 2 ones are 2, and we will get a final one, CaO. Okay, CaO is the formula for calcium oxide. No need to write 1, okay, you can ignore and just write CaO. So this is the formula for calcium oxide. Now let's try to write the formula of zinc hydroxide. Okay, zinc will be Zn2 positive and hydroxide OH single negative. Okay, this is hydroxide radical. Okay, single unit. And Zn2 positive, this is a positive radical and this is a negative radical. So positive radical written always first and then the negative radical. Okay, now the second step is we have to interchange these valencies and keep these numbers at the bottom of the element. Zn2 positive, OH negative, Zn and OH. So valency of the zinc goes to OH and OH valency goes to the zinc. Here 2 from the zinc will go to the bottom of the OH and this will be in the bracket OH. This is for whole, this is a single unit. Okay, so this whole in the bracket and 2 written at the outside, and this 1 negative will come here, so you can ignore 1. So the final formula becomes Zn bracket OH bracket close and 2. So this is the formula for zinc hydroxide. Okay children, now let us understand the last example, that is aluminium nitride. Here I will write the symbol for aluminium, Al, and then for the radical we will be putting the valency 3 positive. So this is aluminium radical, and then nitride radical N3 negative. So 3 positive for aluminium and nitrogen 3 negative. Okay, now we will going to interchange these valencies and put these valencies at the bottom of the elements. Okay, aluminium and nitrogen, here 3 positive goes to the N, which is here at the bottom 3, and for the nitride 3 negative, 3 goes to the aluminium here, Al3. Okay, so the formula is Al3N3. Now this can be simplified further, 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3. Here the formula becomes AlN. So this is the aluminium nitride formula. Okay, students, these are some important compounds which are used commonly in the chemical equations, and you have to remember their chemical formula. कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड कैन बी रिटन एज सी ओ. मोनो मीन्स वन ऑक्साइड, वन ऑक्सीजन ओनली, सो सी ओ. कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, हियर ऑक्सीजन बिकम्स टू, डाई ऑक्सीजन, डाई मीन्स टू, सो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड विल बी रिटन एज सी ओ टू. सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड एस ओ टू. सल्फर ट्राइऑक्साइड, ट्राई ऑक्साइड, थ्री ऑक्सीजन, एस ओ थ्री. नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड एन ओ टू. नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड एन ओ. हाइड्रोजन पेट्रोक्साइड एच टू ओ टू. फॉस्फोरस पेंटो ऑक्साइड, नाउ पेंट मीन्स फाइव ऑक्सीजन, सो पी टू ओ फाइव. रेड लेड ऑल्सो नोन एज ट्राई लेड टेट्रा ऑक्साइड. ट्राई लेड मीन्स ट्राई मीन्स थ्री लेड एटम्स एंड टेट्रा ऑक्साइड फोर ऑक्सीजन एटम्स, सो पी बी थ्री ओ फोर. ओके, ट्राई लेड टेट्रा ऑक्साइड और इट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज रेड लेड ऑल्सो. फेरिक ऑक्साइड एफ ई टू ओ थ्री. फेरस ऑक्साइड एफ ई ओ. ट्राइफेरिक टेट्रा ऑक्साइड, ट्राइफेरिक मीन्स थ्री आयरन एंड टेट्रा ऑक्साइड फोर ऑक्सीजन, द फॉर्मूला बिकम्स एफ ई थ्री ओ फोर. ओके चिल्ड्रन, नाउ हियर दे हैव मेंशनड few very important acids and the bases used in the chemical reactions. You have to learn their chemical formula. Okay, first one is hydrochloric acid, which is written as HCl. Nitric acid and nitrous acid. Okay, nitric acid HNO3. Here three oxygen atoms are there. In nitrous acid there are only two oxygen atoms. So HNO2, two oxygen atoms are there in nitrous. So IC for the more atoms and US you will write for the lesser number of the atoms. Okay, sulfurous acid and sulfuric acid. Sulfurous acid H2SO3, sulfuric acid H2SO4, phosphoric acid H3PO4, carbonic acid H2CO3, sodium hydroxide sodium NaOH, potassium hydroxide KOH, slaked lime, it is Ca in bracket OH and then 2 outside the bracket. This is calcium hydroxide, which is known as slaked lime. Okay, these are very important. Students, that's all for today. Rest topics of this chapter I will take later in my next videos. While explaining the topics, I have given you many examples. Now, this worksheet you have to do in the book only. I have explained you how to make the formulas, how to write the names of the compounds. Kindly do this whole worksheet in the book itself, okay? And do part D, that is match the entries of column A with appropriate entries of the column B in the book only. Okay, this one, answer the following questions. These six questions you can do in your notebook. Okay, answer the following questions please do in your notebook. Rest of the things will be done in the book. Thank you students, and have a nice day.